start this morning with some breaking news. Hurricane Melissa made landfall in Cuba at 3:10 this morning.
It slammed into the island as a Category 3 storm, but it has now weakened to a Category 2. Water is expected to be the biggest threat to Cuba. The storm surge on its southeast coast could reach up to 12 feet.
The hurricane could also drop more than 2 feet of rain in the mountains, triggering flash flooding and landslides. Let's go over to meteorologist Tamara Berg right now.
Yeah, and now this storm track takes it just offshore of Cuba. This is the current track of Melissa, and this is the rewind of the infrared satellite data over the past couple of hours. You can see it's now just offshore of Cuba, now carving a path towards the Bahamas as expected and anticipated for today. Now, the wind speeds have dropped off slightly. Just about an hour ago, they were at 105 miles per hour. Now we're at 100 mile per hour winds. But again, it's still expected to pack quite a punch with heavy rainfall, flooding, flash flooding and damaging winds expected over the Bahamas before it starts to push out in towards Bermuda later in the day and into your Thursday forecast. For more details on the exact track of Melissa, let's bring in meteorologist Ophelia Young in the Weather Center with a closer look.
Yeah, Tamara, Hurricane Melissa has lost some steam, but considering how historically powerful it was, not all are out of the woods yet. Here's Hurricane Melissa on the infrared satellite. Rain bands still as far out through Haiti and the Dominican Republic. A few showers wrapping back, as you can see, into Jamaica. Ground in the high terrain, very saturated now. Those areas on high alert for mud and landslides. With maximum sustained winds falling to 100 miles per hour, it is Category 2. The good news is it is picking up that forward motion speed, moving north-northeast at 14 miles per hour. Compare that to the much slower 7 to 9 miles per hour pace it moved over Jamaica with. Melissa no longer has a defined eye, but it's still centered on Cuba's northeastern coast, and it is expected to remain a two as it crosses parts of the Bahamas today, even as it moves past the Bermuda tomorrow. The one good signal for Bermuda is that Melissa will be moving into waters that are nearly about 10 degrees cooler. Now, warm water is the main fuel for hurricanes, and as Melissa loses access to that, it will hopefully be a weak Category 2 as it slides by Bermuda tomorrow. Still, sustained winds near 100 miles per hour. So large storm surges, heavy rain, and even showers into New England, all of those still on the table through the rest of the week. Back to you, Tamara.
Ophelia, we'll take it from here. Melissa will track directly over southeastern Cuba for the next few hours, bringing damaging wind, flooding, rain, and life-threatening storm surge.
So that storm surge along Cuba's southeast coast could reach above normal tide levels, with large destructive waves making the flooding even worse.
Cuba has been getting blasted all morning since last night. We continue to receive hurricane-strength gusts. You can just hear outside the shrapnel, pieces of roof flying off and hitting.
And right now on the KCR3 app, you can stay updated on the impacts to the Caribbean islands as Melissa moves through the region over the coming days.